I have the pleasure of introducing Ed Nathanson, Director of Talent Acquisition for Rapid7. Rapid7 is a mid-size software security company based in Boston. And when I met Ed for the first time, you kind of meet someone who has a great spirit, kind of makes you laugh when they talk. Ed's that kind of guy. So I can understand why he's in recruiting from a sales perspective, making the close. He's so passionate about what he does. It's infectious for me. He joined Rapid7 in 2011. The company was more of a reactive mode. Ed is a transformation guy. He took this challenge on. He's got some great ideas. He's going to share those ideas with you. So I'm excited to introduce to you Ed Nathanson from Rapid7. Come on, Ed. Pleasure.
Can we hear me?
Can we hear us?
Can you hear me? Ah, here we go. Kosher now.
All right.
Thank you, Pat.
Welcome.
You know, I gotta say, yesterday Chris was up here and he did the whole selfie thing.
I was jealous.
Totally stole our thunder.
I know.
So what I thought I'd do is one up him a bit. Garcon, professional photographer, please. There
wow.
we go. All right. What I ask of all of you is this is the most rock and roll conference I go to and I think is out there. So if you're up for it, could you give the devil's horns in the background?
Yeah,
I think it'd be so sweet.
My children love this.
All right.
Oh, Ed, I'm so excited. All right. All right. Oh,
thank you, Pat.
For that.
Thank you so much.
Bye, guys.
I wasn't looking, so I hope you did it. Super, super excited to be here today and to tell you the story of Rapid7. As Pat mentioned, we are based in Boston, but we have offices in Austin, LA, Toronto, and some sales offices in the UK and Netherlands. Now, sounds big? We're about 400 employees. And I love Talent Connect. This is my third one, and I love meeting everybody and learning new ideas and everything. But if I have one teensy-weensy complaint, it's that you always see the big guys up here with massive budgets and huge amounts of resources. And you know, talking about brand, and I get it, there's challenges there, but come on, everybody knows who they are. There's challenge and then there's challenge. And what I'm gonna walk you through today is our challenge. But thinking back on Chris's, and I loved his presentation yesterday, but thinking back on it, he talked about how he didn't have the Pepsi money. But if he did, he would love to have Beyonce. But considering he didn't, you know, he said, well, you know, I'd do something different. And then I thought about that and I said, well, if I had even a fraction of a fraction of a fraction of what he didn't consider Pepsi money, and I wanted Beyonce, what would I have to do? So just bear with me one second. I love Rapid7. Ed Nathanson is super cute. Thank you, Beyonce. So, I thought I'd start with what we did at the beginning to give you some real insight into, you know, what we're doing, but also to make you understand why you should listen to the guy who looks like Charlotte's husband from Sex and the City. So, for... I get it a lot. First, in 2012 and 2013, we set out with a goal of 100 hires per year. We, not even through Q4 yet, we are at 350 plus, blowing it out of the water. And we are enabling the business to grow at an incredible pace because we are in a white hot sector. All you have to do is pick up the paper every day to see how important security is, in particular software security. So we were able to enable the business to grow far beyond its reach. So everyone's talking about talent brand index and what that means. And you know, for us, we don't have a lot of the tools and mechanisms that a lot of the larger companies do, but I thought the coolest one I wanted to show you to give you an idea of our unique brand and how we go about it and the reach it's had is that our followers on LinkedIn grew almost 500% the last 2 years. And I'm gonna walk you through how we did some of that. We went from low 30% referral hires to almost 50%, a highly engaged employee base who was acting as talent brand ambassadors in conjunction with our team. Our time to fill went from holy crap, to 54 days. No, it was 100 plus to 54 days, and that's getting lower and lower every quarter. Even cooler, we've been voted one of the best places to work in Massachusetts 2 years in a row now. And I used to work at a large software company before coming to Rapid7, and I go back to, you know, the phone call I got from the recruiter who was contacting me to go there potentially. And they said, oh, Rapid7, and then it started sounding like Charlie Brown's teacher. And I was like, rah, 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 rah. And I didn't know who they were, and I didn't have any, you know, compelling reason to think anything of them. Well, now, 2 years later, we've been voted actually last year the number one best place to work in Massachusetts. We also, our LA office, won the award this year as well. So, really, really exciting stuff, and I'm excited to walk you through the journey of how we do it and how we got to where we are today. So first off, when I got to Rapid7, holy moly, talk about the Wild West, almost 100% agency reliant. We had sales doing one thing, engineering doing another thing, marketing doing another thing, and on top of that, there was not even an ATS. Resumes were literally going to an email address and going in an inbox folder. You know, talk about a black hole. You know, there was no value add, but we had big aspirations. A, we're growing incredibly fast in an incredible sector with that highly sought after talent. I was talking to a number of you this week about security folks in general and just the absolute thirst for this skill set now and how scarce it is. So we had to hire fast, we had to hire the right people, and we had to hire the people who are going to fit our unique, and you're going to see what I mean by unique, culture in just a bit. So beyond all that, we were incredibly post and pray. For God's sakes, this guy should have a yarmulke, some rosary beads, some other stuff, because that's what we were doing. What I came in is there was Dice.com, you know, Monster, Career Builder, some guys sitting back on their desk with their arms behind their head, feet up on the desk saying, oh, let the good times roll. Or, hey, let the agencies take care of it. And if we wanted to grow and scale as fast as we wanted to, boy, we had a lot of work ahead of us. So does anyone know this image? Pink Floyd, The Wall, right? And if you don't, I'm going to feel very old. But the reason I have this up here is it was the epitome of wherever I've been, what I try to kill, which is that drive-through mentality in talent acquisition. It's that thought process that, you know, you go up to the drive-through window and you do, I'll take a QA engineer and a receptionist, boom, boom, boom. You keep going, the person, the recruiting team takes that order, they go fill it, here you go, next. You know, order 22. And what value is there in doing any of that? Where's the business being helped by putting butts in seats? Why not go to agency if that's what you're gonna do? So we had to kill that. So, I know the rock star term is cliche. A lot of people use it nowadays. But we drink and eat that stuff. So much so that we actually give out guitar picks as an internal employee recognition. We run contests where people could go to concerts with our executives. Recently, I have a great boss. She's our chief people officer. And to give you some insight into our culture, we actually don't call it human resources. We call it people strategy. The reason being, if you think of humans as resources, you're in the wrong job. So we do really cool stuff, but we really believe in rock and roll. We're working for rock stars. We have a really unique, separate, distinct culture that we love. And so you might disagree with me, and this might be a controversial statement, but the term recruiter doesn't have the best connotation out there, particularly to developers and particularly to folks in security. It's got a kind of that used car salesman, get it off me thing. So we thought about it, and the branding began at the very beginning. Who finds rock stars? Talent scouts finds rock stars. They go to the dingy club, and they see that diamond in the rough, wailing away on the guitar. Sign them to the record contract. So that's where we started. But beyond that, it's a sale. It's a big sale. And I defy you to tell me a more important sale and a more important decision that you're putting and you're closing than anyone. It's people selling software. I say, oh, yeah, I've got this job and this quota and all that. You're selling to someone spending other people's money. A recruiter is selling a life. A job, 40 plus hours a week, who they spend their time with, how they support their family. So We built a really unique incentive plan that a lot of your, if you're not the boss, a lot of your bosses are going to be very upset at me about 10 minutes, that incentivizes those salespeople. Now, if I'm looking for a salesperson, and I've interviewed literally probably thousands in my 20 years, I got to tell you, the good ones are driven by money. They're competitive and they want money. So if I want a great salesperson to work on my team, well, then you've got to pay them. You've got to incentivize them. And in the past, at other companies, and I'm guilty as charged as well, we turn it into the theory of relativity and how we give bonuses. And we really overcomplicate things when, if you really think about it, there's certain core things that you measure. Now, I love data, and I'm hearing all about the big data and all that stuff. And for me, that's up. That's up and how I do strategy. But if I'm motivating a team, I don't want them thinking about time to fill and rec aging and TPS reports. Great office space, brother. But at the end of the day, we're going to incentivize them like salespeople. And before I get into this chart, I will let you know, our top talent scouts earn like top sales performers in our company. Okay? So we're measuring things that matter. First is, are we away from the post and pray? Are we actually getting out there and being aggressive and outreach to the right people and messaging the right way? So we track all of this now. Where did they come from? Was it a job posting? Was it direct sourced on LinkedIn? However we did it, networking, meetups, we're measuring it. Employee referrals. This has always been a pet peeve of mine wherever I've been. It's almost like recruiters are disincentivized on employee referrals. When if you ask this dude's opinion, that's a lot of work. Sometimes it's more work on an employee referral than it is on a regular full cycle hire. So we incentivize our folks, our talent scouts, on employee referrals. They have a big stake in the process. At the end of the day, this is what we're paid to do. We are paid to hire people. And a lot of talent leaders love to complicate this with all this great, you know, smoke and mirrors of data and everything else. At the end of the day, are we successful? Yes, because we're hiring people. Okay, let's not overcomplicate this. We measure that. They are paid on a per hire basis, on a very competitive base, and that goes up. So if it's an individual contributor, then it goes up an additional amount for a manager level and an additional amount for a director level. They're doing anywhere from 4 to, I've seen, 15 a month. You start to think about what they're earning. Some of them out-earned me last year. And I'm super proud of that, because any sales manager should be. I'm successful if they're successful. Retention. So you're saying, oh, wow, it's like you're running on the Brinks truck back up to your talent scouts. They have a big stake in the game with retention. And when my boss and I decided on implementing this plan, we wanted to give people a real stake. And so if they don't make it a certain period of time that we have kept changing and making longer and longer and longer, by the way, we take the money back. Now, we're not asking them to write us a check. We take the next one from them. But again, it's not just putting butts in seats. It's driving the right people into the business. Most importantly, though, again, not having the vast resources that we do, we have to align with the business. We have to get to a place where we are not that Pink Floyd the Wall slide, but something very different, where we're providing that word on the street. We're giving them the data they need, the conditions they need, the ability to make hiring decisions, get ahead of performance plans, all of those good stuff. So I met a lot of really great recruiters this week. None of you are Superman, and all of you are not allergic to kryptonite. So at the end of the day, I don't care how good you are, you cannot be anything and everything to everybody. So you have to, and what we've done, is align by business. There is a talent scout for sales. There is a talent scout for professional services. There is a talent scout for engineering. And what that results in is this beautiful picture, which we all want. If all they're doing all day long is working with a specific sector of business, they know the markets, they know the nooks and crannies of the hiring manager's preferences, and they know how to align themselves with the business so that they're not reactive. They're proactive. They're always thinking. They're ahead of it. They start to get that seat at the table that we always talk about but don't have. If they're consistently working with customers as that trusted advisor, it builds a different relationship, and their work output actually goes towards a pipeline mode because they're constantly looking to continue to fill that pipeline. So I like to say I have my three M's that I kind of built this foundation on. First is we find them. So I'm happy to say that we don't use agencies anymore. We haven't in 2 years. We went from almost a ridiculous dependence to zero. Really cool stuff. We are that aggressive but tasteful, outgoing outreach to people speaking in our language, which I'm going to talk about in a moment. We close them. If you told a salesperson that you could take them to the end, but I'm going to close the deal, they'd laugh in your face. So why would we do that to any recruiter? And we, as the true talent scout in the process, are doing just that. We are the agent between the candidates and our hiring managers. But most importantly, we advise them. We do play that part now because they're so aligned with the business, because the right behaviors are being driven. Not how long are recs aging, but are they hiring the right person? Are they sourcing them? Are they thinking about retention? Are they thinking about fit? We're using tools like Predictive Index, which is an awesome behavioral assessment tool, to build teams where we're thinking about if we have a person who's a super alpha, do we bring in another one? Yikes. We're actually having those conversations, which at the end is value. At the end, you are no longer Pink Floyd the Wall. So, moving on to the brand. If you know security, you definitely know Rapid7. It's wacky, but these security gearhead guys, I've seen people of them with tattoos of our products. That's how passionate they are about them. But outside of that, no one knows who we are. So how do we tackle that from the very beginning, from the very ground floor, without the massive budget, without the massive resources at our disposal? So I watched a video, a TED video, about 3 years ago. And I'm not going to bore you with the big details of it, but if you ever want to see it, it's by Simon Sinek, and it's The Power of Why. And he talks about particularly Apple. And why does Apple literally have people sleeping on cold streets to buy something that's either slightly better than what they already have, or quite frankly, they don't even know what it does yet? Wow, that's so cool. So as he talks through it, and I'm going to use a comparison, Samsung, a lot of people love Androids. They think they're the most wonderful phone in the world. And it probably is. But you know what? If you watch how they sell, Samsung's always talking about, we've got the fastest processor. We've got the cleanest, crispest keyboards, whatever it is. Next time you watch an Apple commercial, and this is what's talked about in the video, think about how they sell. Do they ever talk about features? No. They're talking about what they believe in, and they're putting it out there for people to either identify with and become passionate about or tap out. And so I thought about that, and I thought about this lovely picture up here. And I, you know, as someone who loves to watch how other companies do things, I see this far too often. Vanilla. Want to be everything and everyone, everything to everybody. So when we designed, and I'm going to talk about partnering with marketing in a moment, but when we designed with marketing about what we wanted to do, we said, let's go all in. Let's do it. So we're going to be us, whoever we are in all its hideousness or all its glory, however you look at it. And at the beginning, we said, we understand and want people to tap out at the end. We want those people, and you'll see in some of the language you use, you say, it's us, it's not you. But if you think it's funny, you think it's quirky, whatever it is that rings with you, that shared why, that shared belief system, come on in. You are going to love us. So without a budget, we had to get scrappy at first. And yes, that's jib jab, and yes, that's me in midair doing a shh. But at the end of the day, believe it or not, this stuff started to work. So we used it around colleges, and it's free, of course. And we track this in our ATS, how they find us, and now with cool LinkedIn feature about how I can see my updates are doing with engagement. Again, this stuff got traction, and it shows how quirky we are. But I'm going to show you some more. You're going to either be horrified or love it. That's our landing page and our careers page. When people click on rapid7.com careers, they see three of our employees looking menacingly at the camera shooting with, we are not everybody. We're not for everybody. So think about that for a second. It's, again, wanting the right people to love it, wanting the wrong people for us to tap out. Culture for us is the biggest driver. I know we all talk about culture fit, but we know who's successful with us. And we want to be honest and genuine about what that success looks like as we move through the process. Here's some more images that I thought you might find interesting before I actually show you some of this stuff. In the top corner, our marketing team did that. That's our 300, when we reached our 300th hire. They sent that out, and I thought it was pretty neat. Although, why couldn't they put my head on one of those ripped bodies? And you see here is some of our series of Rapid 7 at the Movies series, which I'm going to show you one of a bit. So we took our core values, and we put them in purposefully, horribly made videos. We did not want professional people coming in doing our stuff, because that's not us. It's too polished, too slick. We're scrappy, we're passionate, we're energetic. And so, I'm gonna show you next one. This video that I'm about to show you here was actually just nominated for Video of the Year in Massachusetts High Tech Leadership Council, and has driven an incredible amount of traffic to us. It exemplifies our passion core value, and it's a parody of Flashdance. Enjoy.
Yeah, great. Yeah, we're really happy to have you as a customer. Okay, bye-bye. How can I help you?
So you see, yeah, I heard some laughing, which is good, but I guarantee you there's a lot of people who looked and said, what the heck was that crap? And didn't apply. Perfect. Worked. So, on top of that, I thought it'd be cool to share with you that as company as lean and as mean as we are, we actually have a role that is only candidate experience. She's here, so if you want to talk with her afterwards, I'm sure she'd love to chat. But she owns that brand through the experience. Again, just because we've got you interested now doesn't mean that stops. We have to continue it. So what you see here is some screenshots of what someone receives when they get an invitation to interview from us with directions, but they also get a video directions from us, again, cheaply made. And to give my favorite one is the Los Angeles one. These are just some screenshots from it. But from the Los Angeles one, one of our talent scouts, Candace, is actually rapping directions to the Fresh Prince of Bel-Air over these stuff. So in the Boston one, we do the shipping up to Boston from Departed. It's, again, our style, embracing it, and knowing that. So the person got through the first filter, but then they get to this, and they're like, huh, what is that? Again, out. But if you love it, in. So the other really key thing from the very beginning is a real partnership with the PR aspect of marketing, which is often overlooked when you think about the brand piece. And we have the most wonderful woman who is our director of PR, and she got it from the very beginning when I joined. She knew that A, hiring was the most important thing we had to do, especially if she wanted to do what she needed to do, but B, she knew that we didn't have the awareness out there and we needed to do it. So literally, she got started on it, the PR agency that we hired started on it, and they got me, our executives, every opportunity we could to talk about A, our unique style, but B, hey, we're hiring. And lo and behold, stuff started to get out there. Articles started being written about what we're doing. And we started getting featured in a lot of the publications that you see here. It really started to snowball from there. So, would it surprise you to know that the Rapid 7 handle on LinkedIn is me? How many companies let their head recruiting guy run their LinkedIn page, the company page? We do. Now, like Uncle Ben and Spider-Man said, with great power comes great responsibility. I'm not constantly putting out employment stuff. I use it with responsibility. I use the marketing aspects of it. I do product updates. I do company press releases. But I am putting out the recruiting stuff there, and it's driving followers, and it's that engagement you see that got us to 500% growth over the last 2 years. So, and again, being scrappy without the budget, memes are awesome. I love memes. This is one we did for our college outreach that we're doing with Theodore Ted Logan from Bill and Ted's, one of my favorites. The other big thing I think about the branding is how your recruiters and talent scouts engage with people. I gotta tell you, it's like nails on a chalkboard when I watch these in my feed, fantastic work environment, great company, I'm hiring, right? Snooze fest, and you sound like Optimus Prime, truly. It becomes spam. Don't be that guy. What you want to do is have a voice. Be a person. Be passionate. Be the ambassador of who your company is. So again, you'll see just a few samples here. You see Julie on the team who's talking about sharing an article she had, but tying it back to Rapid7 and our core values and what we do. Or even me, I saw this, look at that thing. That's so cool. A Star Wars sun visor looks like the Millennium Falcon. So cool. Putting that out there, I'm not hammering people over the heads with jobs 24/7. It becomes noise. Be a person. And this is something I think you also might find interesting, is that every new sales class I get in front of in their first week, and most of our employees I also do, and we teach social media. We talk about how to embrace it. Our marketing does it as well. We talk about embracing it, and we have some rules. One is be responsive. Actually be a human being. Talk to people. Don't be a one-way street. Be relevant. Don't be talking about Homer Simpson one day and then security threats the next. And be a person. Again, don't be that robot. I'm watching you now after today. So, at the end of the day, what this all did is increased our department perception. Is at an all-time high? We are at the table. We are parts of new expansion conversations, planning, business plans, international expansion. We are at that table. A qualified pipeline, being aligned with the right businesses. The speed of hire, as you saw, has dramatically increased without, by the way, incentivizing for it. Quality of hire, with giving them that stake in the ground, has increased dramatically. The business partnership is at an all-time high, never been better. Brand awareness went from nothing to off the charts, where we are the hot company now in Massachusetts and Austin and LA, which, oh, by the way, are also really tech hotbeds. So I thought I'd finish with one last video. I talked about our candidate experience. This is what you're about to see is what our candidate experience person came up with, which is they get an email the week before they start with us after they've accepted, and again, continuing the brand through the whole process. They get an email saying something to the effect of, we're so excited we hired you, we feel like champions. We made this video for you just to welcome you. And what they see, what you're seeing here is our CEO, our VP of sales, and our CFO making cameos as well. So please.
I've paid my dues time after time. I've done my sentence, but committed no crime. And bad mistakes, I've made a few. I've had my shadow plan kicked in my face, but I've come through.
And I need to go on, 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 on.
We are the champions, my friends, and we'll keep on fighting till the end.
Pretty different, huh? Thank you very much.